Good evening, doctors. Myself, Dr. Hemant Sharma, and today I am going to explain you about macrocytic anemias. What is it, macrocytic anemias? The definition shows the MCV, its mean corpuscular volume. I want to ask question with, yes, Mr. Deepak, please fill here how much MCV in macrocytic anemia. Right, yes, this time he is absolutely right. And more than 100 is macrocytic anemia, 70 till 90 is normal, but in macrocytic there is large MCV volume by nearly 100. So thank you, Deepak. Thank you. For giving such a wonderful answer here. So please show.
100,
yeah, nice. Now it's responsible for maturation. This macrocytic anemia is responsible for maturation. If there is a deficiency of MCV, that's why there is immature cells development. And causes of macrocytic anemia: vitamin B12 deficiency, folic acid deficiency, malnutrition, gastritis, Crohn's disease or terminal ileum, pregnancy also, strict vegetarian diet, chronic liver diseases, and alcoholism, and post GI surgery and hypothyroidism. So I am going to explain you what about the macrocytic anemia, why this happens in pathology. Pathophysiology: MMA is methylmalonic acid, and it converts into methylmalonic coenzyme. Then in presence of vitamin B12, it converts into succinyl coenzyme. What happens in next step, homocysteine converts into folic acid, then folic acid in presence of B12, it's converted into methionine. Please, camera bring near, so going to be visible more. Methionine. Then how to identify the deficiency of vitamin B12 and folic acid? So in vitamin B12, what was happened? Methylmalonic coenzyme increases. Why? Because if there is a blockage here in this pathway, vitamin B12 not sufficient, so methylmalonic acid going to be stored, not going to convert into succinyl coenzyme. That's why the methylmalonic acid increases. And homocysteine also increases because there is no vitamin B12. But what was going to be happen in folic acid deficiency? The methylmalonic acid level going to be normal. Why this is normal? Because here the deficiency of only folic acid. In folic acid deficiency, only folic acid deficiency. So methylmalonic acid convert into methylmalonic coenzyme, then vitamin B12, and then succinyl coenzyme. Okay. And what is going to be happen in homocysteine and folic acid? If folic acid, no folic acid, then what was going to be happen? Homocysteine level going to be increase in folic acid deficiency, because folic acid not going to be not sufficient. So homocysteine increases, not going in a pathway. What is the diagnosis difference between vitamin B12 causes macrocytic anemia, folic acid deficiency cause macrocytic anemia, and pernicious anemia cause deficiency of macrocytic anemia? Vitamin B12 deficiency occurs after 2-3 years, because this vitamin B12 is stores in a liver. So after 3 years, its neurological symptoms occurs, like we can say paresthesia, some pain in the knees, tingling sensations, dementia, sometime now disorder. But see here, it's symptom neurological due to deficiency of vitamin. And what was going to see in macrocytic vitamin B12 deficiency, we see hypersegmented neutrophils. This is known as basophilic stippling. Here the lobes must be more than 60, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 7 hypersegmented neutrophils we see here. And vitamin B12 level sufficient is more than 270, till 1000 it's normal level, below 270 it's deficiency, and severe insufficiency is less than 100. And how to treat vitamin B12 deficiency? We need an injection vitamin B12. It's 100 microgram intramuscular. We are going to give till 7 days, 1 OD once daily, every day till 7 days. Then once weekly, only one injection in a 1 week. Then once monthly, only one injection in a month. It's an Indian criteria, but in US criteria is different. Okay. In USA, we are going to give injection 1 OD 1 week, then alternate days. Okay, and this one monthly, once a month, lifelong, lifetime you need to take. In folic acid deficiency, what was happened? Folic acid storage is only for 3 months, only for 3 months. We see this folic acid only in vegetables, and those who are taking sulfur drugs and phenytoin, they are suffering from this disease, folic acid. And how to treat this folic acid deficiency? By 1 gram tablet folic acid once daily, every day you need to take. And I already explained how to diagnose. So if you want to diagnose vitamin B12 deficiency, go for vitamin B12 level. It's very much easy, very much easy. So you are going to get vitamin B12 deficiency easily. And if you want to differentiate between vitamin B12 deficiency and folic acid deficiency, you have to check these levels also. Now I am going to explain you where we see vitamin B12 deficiency in strict vegetarians we mostly found in India, like they don't like to drink even milk and nothing. So that's why they have vitamin B12 deficiency. Milk contain vitamin B12, eggs contain, and non-vegetarian products like fish, chicken, they all contain a B12. But those who are strict vegetarian, even not drinking milk, they have suffering from B12 deficiency. But I am going to explain you pernicious anemia. What is it, pernicious anemia? It's a deficiency of intrinsic factor. What is intrinsic factor? You know about pancreatic cell. In our stomach, we have a cell. Then it secrete intrinsic factor. Okay. If there is deficiency of intrinsic factor, I am going to explain you. See, this is a male. His eyes, his mouth. When vitamin B12 enters into the saliva came in contact, it binds with R factor. When the R factor is bind with B12, B12 is a boyfriend and R factor is like a girlfriend. So they bind together, and what happens, the pancreatic protease enzyme came together here, and this done a work. Pancreatic protease separate R factor from B12. Now vitamin B12 is alone. So now another girl like intrinsic factor girl bind with the vitamin B12 here. And B12, how we secrete intrinsic factor? Parietal cell has secreting HCl and intrinsic factor. This parietal cell secrete intrinsic factor, and then when the intrinsic factor see a girl, this girl find B12 is alone, now he is joining with it, and then goes to the terminal ileum, and terminal ileum the vitamin B12 absorption. So I already explained Crohn's disease. In Crohn's, there is a disease, patches occurs in terminal ileum, that's why no absorption of vitamin B12 with intrinsic factor. In case of genital TB, like terminal ileum is the most common place. And what kind of test? We see the Schilling test. It's an old past test. In 2000 century, nobody will ask you such test for pernicious anemia. Now we are going to see the test like anti-intrinsic factor, antibodies level. We have to measure. So my dear friends, till here I already explained you about macrocytic anemias. And thank you, Mr. Deepak. Thank you again for giving a brilliant answer in my lecture. He is really actively participating. And welcome, Dr. Emily, on last of my lecture. Please come here. He is taking a part and brilliantly. Okay. Now, he is also actively partaking in my lecture. So please subscribe my channel. If you still not subscribe it, please subscribe it. My aim to spread the knowledge in everybody. Thank you. Thank you. And that's all for today.